Hello students, stay home, stay safe and classics. In this particular video we will be moving towards the next part and we will be starting it. We will be discussing about the next landforms. One we have discussed about the mountains. Now we have to discuss about the valleys, and after that we will be discussing about the plateaus and its types also. The next form we will be discussing is your plains, and again the different types of plains. All these things will be covered in this video. The very first one is your valleys, its types. Then second one is your plateaus and its types. The third one is your plains and its types. We will be discussing all these things in detail in this particular video. So watch this video for understanding all these things, all these landforms in detail. Starting with the river valley, I have an activity for you that this is the river valley. You can see that this is the river valley. I have drawn the river valley, written the river valley over here, and I have used clay to form these two mountains and show that this is the valley formed as V shape. You can see that this is V shaped in, it looks like a V. You can see from here also it looks like a V. So this way you can use the clay and you can form the mountains, the small mountains, and the river is coming from here and it moves like this. The erosion is there, and due to the erosion the river valley is formed and it looks like V in a shape. Moving towards the next one is your glacial valley. You can see that due to the glaciers it is U-shaped. Okay, it is U-shaped, it is not like this. You can see it is U-shaped. You can see from here also it seems like U-shaped. Okay, so this is activity based learning, so you should do activities like this, and this will help you to remember things in a better way, as you have drawn, as you have made all these things on your own. Again, river valley V-shaped, glacial valley U-shaped. Just the reason is that the glaciers, they are passing, the it is moving from this part, the flow is in this way, so that's why they are wide apart from each other, so it looks like a V. Then talking about your rift valley, again they are block mountains. These are block mountains, these two, this one and this one, these two are block mountains, and due to the divergent forces taking action upon them, they moved apart from each other. There was a gap which was filled by the part of mud, silt, whatever was present, it was moved downwards. It moved downwards, and due to that this rift valley was formed. Even the water also comes in this type of rift valleys. We will be discussing about that also, the river coming from that particular part. So this is your rift valley. In this way you can form a rift valley. Rift valley is also known as grebens. This we have discussed also, that it is also known as grebens. The basin, if this basin is filled up with the water, it is filled up with the water and forms a lake also. It forms a lake. And two lakes also are there of this kind. Then again the glacial valley, I am showing you the glacial valley. You can see U-shaped, again river valley V-shaped. So this way you have to make some mountains. In this way you can see, you can make the mountains, and then you have to arrange them, that whether it is a river valley, glacial valley or rift valley. So this way you will be learning in a better way. It is a better way of learning when you are making things on your own and talking about them, thinking about them. So this is it about the valleys. As you have seen in the video, in the previous part, that the valleys are of different types. I have shown you with the help of the clay. Now we will be discussing about the valleys. What the valleys are, this we have discussed earlier also, that they are the low-lying areas. They are present between the hills or the mountain ranges. So there are three different types of valleys. The very first one is your river valley, second is your glacial valley, and third one is your rift valley. We have discussed about them
And now we will be discussing certain features which were left. The very first one, the river valleys, they are formed due to the erosion, due to the erosive action. The rivers, they cause erosion due to which the river valleys are formed. And this is very much clear that when the gradient is very steep, steeper gradient means like, you know, the steeper slope. So when the gradient is, if the river is flowing, like I can show you, if you see this cardboard, you can see it is like this. If it is this way, from this part you can see, if I have kept it here like this, so this is the slope. So the way the river moves is its gradient, and from what height or which kind of area it is moving, it tells us about the gradient. If the gradient is steeper, you can see in this way it is steeper, it in this way it is flatter. If it is lying towards the ground, it is flatter. So if it is flatter, the lower gradient is there, then the flatter valleys are formed, and the slopes are also very gentle, and the walls are gentle sloping walls are there. So if we talk about the rivers in the river valleys, they have steep gradient, means they have a very good speed. So due to them, the V-shaped valleys are formed, while if they have lower gradient, the flatter valleys are formed. Next is your glacial valleys. When we talk about the glacial valleys, the shape you have seen, it is U-shaped valley, and they have steep and almost the vertical walls. The walls of the mountains, they look almost vertical, and they have flat bottoms. The bottoms are very much flatter. Rift valley, this we have discussed earlier also, in the previous one also we have discussed that they are also known as grebens. So they are formed when there are some cracks in the earth's crust. The parallel cracks are there, due to which they move apart, and a distance or a path or a depth is created, which is filled by the silt or the deposited mud which is present in the mountains. Next is some important names which we have to discuss. The Great Rift Valley in East Africa, the Rhine Rift Valley, it is in Europe, the Narmada Rift Valley is in India. So it is very important, as it is in our own country, so it is very important. Sometimes I have discussed that the basin is filled up with the water to form a lake. So such lake, there are two lakes, such lakes are Lake Baikal in Siberia and Lake Tanganyika. It is Tanganyika in Africa. Okay, so these are the two lakes which are formed due to the Rift Valley, the water occurring in them. These two lakes are formed due to that. Talking about the plateaus, when you have to talk about the plateaus, the very simple thing is that you have to imagine a table, and you have to imagine that, as you know, the table is high up as the floor is there, so it is steeper from one side. The plateau is steeper at least from one side. It is slightly higher at some height, it is there. So it, the top is like a tabletop, so they are also known as table lands. This have been written over here also, this I have written this. Next is your Deccan Plateau, which is in India, and it is very important. It is divided into hill as well as into valley landscape. Both are there. Hills are also there and valleys also there. And it is divided by major rivers. And major rivers are like, which major rivers they pass through the Deccan Plateau? They are Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. Due to the action of these rivers, the Deccan Plateau is divided into hill and valley landscape. So I have written over here also that the plateaus are known as table lands. Deccan Plateau in India, it is important as it is present in India. Next, talking about the types. So types, again, we have three types of plateaus. The very first one is the continental plateau. The second one is intermontane plateau. And third one is volcanic. Volcanic, as the name is telling us, that it is formed due to the volcanic action. So when the sheets of lava turnwise turn after some time, after again the volcanic eruption is there, again the sheet is forming there, accumulating there, so due to that it forms, it is known as which plateau? Volcanic plateau. And the Deccan Plateau in India is a type of volcanic plateau. talking about the intermontane plateaus, the plateaus which are surrounded by the mountains, intermontane, montane, mountains, inter, between the mountains. So this plateau which is surrounded by the mountains is known as intermontane plateau. The plateau of Tibet and the Altiplano plateau, which is present in South America, both are the examples of intermontane plateaus. Continental plateau, it is formed when the forces are generated within. Within means the earth is pushing out the block of the crust upwards. It is due to the natural action of the earth. The forces are acting within the earth and they are pushing up the area, a large block of the crust upwards, due to which the continental plateau is formed. So the Chota Nagpur plateau in India is a continental type of plateau. So this thing you have to remember, that Chota Nagpur plateau is continental and the volcanic one is our Deccan plateau. So these two plateaus are very important. Now we will be talking about the plains. When we talk about the plains, it is very important that you see that plains are not having height more than 200 meters of the sea level, above the sea level. They are the flat areas, or they are the rolling lands. Okay, they are the flat areas. Mostly you see the plains are very much flatter, and they are not they have a height of approximately 200 meters above the sea level, not more than that. If they are having the height more than that, they are not called plains. So they are known as lowlands. The reason being, the lowlands, why are they called lowlands? The reason is that they are low-lying areas. Their height is not very much above the sea level, so they are known as lowlands. Three types are again, we have three types of valley, three types of plateaus, and again three types of plains: structural, depositional, and erosional plains. Starting with the structural plains, they are found, or they are formed in the areas when the crust, when our crust is not facing any disturbance from within, or it has been left undisturbed for a long period of time. So it is very much flatter and it is not disturbed by anything, so it is stable as well. So this kind of plains are known as, such kinds of plains are known as structural plains. So these plains are called structural plains, and the examples are the East European plain of Russia, the Great Plains of North America, and Central Lowlands of Australia. They are not having any, you can say, disturbance from within the earth's crust. So due to that, they are very much stable and relatively flat as compared to the other lands. The next one is your depositional lands, depositional plains. As the word is telling us, deposition. Deposition means that the erosion winds, the erosion agents like river, wind, waves, glaciers, etc., they are acting upon and they are bringing something along with them. Something which can be alluvial soil, alluvial, you can say, deposition with them, or loess with them. Okay, so both these kinds of depositions are brought with the help of these erosion agents. So they are divided into two parts again. The very first one is the alluvial plains and the second one is loess plains. Starting with alluvial plains, this is particularly formed when the rivers are into action, when they are taken into action, or they act, they brought, or they bring with them, they have brought in the earlier times, or they have to bring in the future also, and they are bringing also. So they are bringing some amount of fine particles of silt, clay, as well as some sand is also brought by these rivers. So it is known as alluvium. The plains which are rich with alluvium, they are alluvial plains, and this particular alluvium is brought by the rivers. So the very good example of this is the Indo-Gangetic plain. The Indus River and the Ganga River both are bringing the alluvium, and they are depositing it in the northern plains, that is our Indo-Gangetic plains. The second one is the fertile plains that are along the bank of Nile River. Talking about the Laos plains, these are formed by again, the agents are the erosional agents only, but they are now wind and glaciers, not the rivers. So what is loess? It is the fine material, the rich material, which is formed due to wind erosion. Alluvium, it was brought with the help of rivers in the lands, different areas. But this is brought due to the action of wind. So such kind of plains are present in Argentina, and they are known as pampas. Okay, the pampas in Argentina are the type of loess plains which are under depositional plains. So depositional plains are of two types. Again, the two types are based on the erosional agents only, the alluvial and the loess plains. Erosional plains are telling you that they are caused due to erosion. If the river, rain, wind, they erode the surface of the earth. Over the million of the years, they act on the mountains, the hills, or the other rugged surfaces which are not very much plain or flatter. They act upon them, they erode them, and due to them, the plains are formed. Okay, then generally they are the gentle rolling plains are formed due to the erosional actions of river, rain, wind, etc. So these plains are caused. These are the formation is due to the erosion. The erosion is done, and due to that erosion, the land or the plains are formed. That particular plain is known as erosional plains. But when we are talking about the depositional plains, they are formed with the help of the agents, which are the erosional agents, but the material brought by them is used to form that plain. So this is the difference between these two plains. And the plains of the Northern Europe and Canada, they are formed due to the erosion, and they are known as the erosional plains. So they are created by the erosional work of the glaciers. Basically, these two are created by the Canada, the one in Canada and Northern Europe. They are created due to the erosional action of the glaciers. So this was all about your plains. So we will be revising. The very first one was your valley. Valley is again of three types. We have discussed it also. The very first one was, which was having V shape, was your river valley. Then the U shaped one was your glacial valley. Third one was your rift valley, which we have discussed earlier also. Rift valley is formed due to, and the mountains along the rift valley are block mountains. Then talking about the plateaus, we have discussed the three types of plateaus: continental, intermontane, and volcanic. Volcanic are due to the volcanic action, intermontane are surrounded by the mountains, and continental are formed due to the inner forces which are present in the earth's crust, and they push certain amount of crust outwards, due to which they are formed. Plains, again, they are known as lowlands, and they are of three types: structural, depositional, and erosional. Depositional plains are again of two types: alluvial plains and the loess plains. So this way we have done three landforms. We have discussed about them in this video, and before this we have discussed about the mountains. So we have covered four types of landforms, and we have discussed about them. Their examples also we have discussed. So after this video, I want, or I request, you can say, all of you to do a thing, that if you are having a clay with you, so try to form all those mountains and the valleys I have shown you in your own way. Use your own creativity and try to do more creativity in learning. Whenever you are learning, learn in a creative way. Don't mug up the things. Dear children, don't feel overburdened. If you feel like that something is troubling you, you can ask me. If you are facing any problem, you can write in the comment section and ask me your doubt. I'll be giving you the answer whenever possible and as soon as possible. So add creativity in learning. Enjoy learning. Take care. Stay home. Stay safe. Thank you.